Hi everyone, Ifeoma Green is my name and this is my daughter Ibimina.
Hello.
Welcome to our channel IG's Business Forum. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Don't forget to like our videos. On Facebook we're IG's Business Forum and on Instagram we're IG's Business Forum. I am going to teach us how to secure our Facebook, Instagram and WhatsApp accounts with the two-factor authentication method. So
please subscribe to my mom's channel, you'll love it.
Yeah, the channel is to help you grow your business online. So watch and tell people about us. Thank you.
Bye.
Did it go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. Hey, can't let this one.
Two-factor authentication for all your apps, Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram. People are really hacking into people's accounts. I'm going to quickly show us how to do the three of them. So this is my Facebook. You click on settings. This is your settings here. It will show you your menu. Different Facebook accounts show different things. If this is how you own it, just look for settings and privacy. You go to settings, you come here. Because it's settings you want to come to. When you click on settings, you come to security. This is your security here. Then you click on security. See what it's showing you. Either you choose three to five friends who can help you when you're locked out of your account. Most people, their accounts are being hacked, so you can't even trust anybody. Now, let me show you an example. Look at my where I have been logged in. You'll see people that have tried to hack me. When I click here now, you'll see. See all. Someone tried to hack me on the 24th of April in Lakwe. The device type is unknown. It's not me. My phone is Android. Listen, once you see device type unknown, it's a hacker that tried to hack in. Look at Port Harcourt. I've not been to Port Harcourt this year. It's a hacker. So that's to give you an idea of the fact that they are always working. They can tell you to change your password. It's another good idea, but there are apps that can generate passwords. So it might not work. But the best thing to do is this two-factor authentication. Look at it, this two-factor authentication, that is what everybody is doing everywhere. What it means is that anytime someone tries to log in and they will ask you if it's you, once it's not you, they tell you to change your password or they block the person out. So when you click on two-factor authentication, this is what you get. It's on because I've turned my own on. That's why when you open an account, remember the phone number. But if you don't remember the phone number you use, they will ask you to provide a phone number. Once you provide the phone number, they will send you a message on that phone number, which you will take and input here, and it will be turned on. Now, there's something they do again. It's called recovery codes. When you finish, they will ask you, do you want recovery codes? I already have recovery codes. Well, let me click it so that you will see. See, my recovery codes are already there. I have codes. So I'll click on show codes. These are my codes. Because I've shown you my codes, I'm going to remove the codes. Let me show you how to remove the codes. Show codes. These are my codes. These are the new codes, the codes I have. Now, you have seen my codes. I'm going to get new codes. I'll click here. Get new codes. So that in case someone who has access to this class get my codes, they cannot use it. So I'll click get my codes. When I get my codes, I click on copy codes. And I'll copy them and save them somewhere. What it does is, anytime, let's say the phone you use to open Facebook, you can't access the phone. With that code, you can access your Facebook. It is the fastest way to prove that you are the owner of that account. So now I'm going to go over to WhatsApp, then I'll go over to Instagram. So I come over to Instagram. Remember what I said, you go always go to your menu. This is menu. These three dots on the left. When you click your menu, you come to settings. This is settings, it's down. When you click settings, it brings you here. And we go to security once again. This is security. You click on security. You come to two-factor authentication. Two-factor authentication. You click it once again. It's going to show you. For me, it is on. All my apps are secured. But if it's not, if yours is not on, you just follow the instruction. You will tell them, when you switch it on, which is here, they will send you a code to the phone number you are using. It's always advised to use a text message. The authentication app is neither here nor there. It's in your phone and you can lose your phone. They will send you a message. After sending you a message, you come here again to the recovery codes. And you take your recovery code and you save it. It's very, very simple, but it will save you. Anytime someone tries to log into your phone, immediately they will give you a notification. I remember the other day, a student of mine, she had issues with her account. She wanted me to look at it. Immediately I logged in, she got a notification. Somebody logged into your account. And she called me, she said, "Is this you?" I said, "Yes." It's very, very important. Now I'm going over to WhatsApp. So we are now on WhatsApp. You come to settings again. Account, that's where you're going to. You can see privacy, security, and change of number. When you click your account, you come to two-step verification again. You can see two-step verification. When you click on two-step verification, mine is already on. Mine is already on. If I disable it, I will change my PIN. I will change my email address. So all you have to do is enable it. Once you enable it, they send a message to your phone number again. When they send the message to your phone number, you give them a PIN. Make sure you write down the PIN somewhere so that you don't forget it. Sometimes when you want to log into WhatsApp, it will ask you, "What's your PIN?" Make it a simple PIN that you will always remember. Add your email address. They will always send you a message if someone is trying to hack into your WhatsApp. It is so simple that anybody can do it, just that people don't know it. Make sure you do it now to secure your account. Cheers and God bless.